are on the record.
Okay, I call the meeting of the Civil Service Board to order. Today is November the 15th, 2012. It's approximately 10 a.m. We're meeting in the Public Safety Complex on Setting Down Road. So, gentlemen, do I hear a motion to adopt our agenda?
So moved.
A second.
Motion and a second to adopt the agenda. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Gentlemen, have you had time to read the minutes from the October the 11th meeting?
Yes, sir.
Any corrections or additions? If not, do I hear a motion to approve?
I make that motion, Mr. Chairman.
Second.
Motion and a second to adopt the minutes from the October 11th meeting. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. We'll move into our items for consideration and discussion. The number one item, Mr. Miles.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The county had filed a motion to dismiss the writ of certiorari filed by John Gooch on procedural grounds. That went for hearing in front of Judge Bagley. He issued an order since your last meeting that, in essence, denied the county's motion to dismiss and found that Mr. Gooch had substantially complied with all procedural requirements in order to file a writ of cert. And so now the case will move to a consideration on the merits. And there was the procedural challenge by the county was denied, and now they will consider his writ of cert, or Judge Bagley will, on the merits. And to my knowledge, no hearing date has been set on that merits portion of the case. But that's the update.
Okay. Item number
no action required by the board. That's just a report.
Okay. Item number two, Ms. Carr, our yes. appointment to the Board of Ethics.
Yes, sir, Mr. Chairman. The latest update on the Board of Ethics is that tonight at the Board of Commissioners regular meeting, they will have on their agenda for consideration moving the public hearing for considering to move to an ethics panel. I know council did report at the last work session that they have received an ethics complaint, and my understanding that was that the personnel services director, Ms. Carson, and Mr. Gerard, county attorney, was going to reach out to some of the existing board members to hold over to hear this appeal until the new panel could be finalized. So that is the status update. The appointment of Mr. Twiner has not been made. It was postponed. However, I do believe council has reached out to him to potentially hold over for this pending complaint.
Although it has nothing to do with this board other than Mr. Twiner, do they have a full board to hear that?
My understanding is that they may have enough to have a quorum.
Okay. Item number three, the status update on the election of the employee representative to the Civil Service Board.
Mr. Chairman, yesterday we opened the nominations for the employee representative to the Civil Service Board. The Board of Commissioners had adopted the new policy for the election process, which allows the nomination period to be 20 calendar days. So the nomination period will end on December 4th. 2012, we have 10 days from that date to begin an election. I'm looking at the week of the 17th to actually hold elections. The election period must remain open for 5 days. So I fully expect that we will have our representative identified by the week of the 24th. However, they would not be appointed until the first work session of January, is what I'm looking at right now.
Which that would be January the 2nd?
That would be, yes. Actually, that would be January the 8th. Tuesday, January 8th.
Would be their first work
their
session.
Their first work session in
and
January.
And then if they approved it, then what? That would have to go to the full board meeting on
they
the Thursday.
Would. They would, yes,
and
they
would
ratify
be,
consent. We could do it as time sensitive, and it would be, it would happen, you know, that day it would be in effect if it's approved.
At the work session?
At the work session if we do time sensitive, and then it would be in effect for the first meeting of January 2013 for the Civil Service Board, or then it would, if not, if it wasn't time sensitive, then it would be approved at the January 17th Board of Commissioners meeting.
And what do you have to do to make it time sensitive?
You just request that it be considered time sensitive and the board can put that in their motion.
Could I make here a motion? Y'all want to discuss that, making it time sensitive? Does it suit y'all? Can I hear a motion that we request that Ms. Clark make the appointment time sensitive?
I make that motion to do that.
Second.
It's a motion to make our appointment for the employee representative time sensitive, speed things up. Any discussions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion's unanimous.
Mr. Chairman, I will also state that my intent is also at that same meeting just to go ahead and do all the housekeeping items for the Civil Service Board. And we can address this at our December meeting, but to bring before the Board of Commissioners your appointment for clerk and hearing officer for 2013 at that same meeting.
Okay. That'll be fine. So we're going to put that on the agenda for the December meeting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The final item on the agenda is the election of our elected official, which are the third person on our board. As per our handbook, the public official representative, which is myself, and the employee representative, which is Mr. Perry, our temporary member, get together and decide on a third person to be the third member of our board.
Let me ask a question if I could.
Yes, sir.
Chairman, has the revised policy 2 passed the board yet?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. I think under the revised policy 2, they call it the neutral member. And
okay.
That's the new nomenclature that has now been adopted by the Board of Commissioners, I guess based on what the county attorney drafted.
Yes.
I think it's called a neutral
member.
Neutral
member, yes.
So
sir.
Under our old policy 2, it was called the third member.
Yeah.
And now it's called the neutral member. So you're referred to as the official's representative or the official's member. Mr. Perry would be the employee representative member. And whoever the two of you elect is now called the neutral member. So I just think our minutes need to be consistent with the new policy to
leave. Yes, that's correct.
Mr. Perry, do you have any ideas on our neutral member?
Well, certainly having known Dr. Howell my entire life and knowing him to be a man of character and integrity, not to mention his 19 or 20 years of service on this board. I think he's been an asset to the Civil Service Board and the entire county, and if he would consider, I would like to nominate Dr. Howell to continue to serve in that capacity.
Dr. Howell, would you be willing to serve another 4-year term?
I will be 94. I've been telling you for a long time. I'm getting old. April, coming up, I'll be 90. Your day would be 90.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think you're having a problem with this, but if I go 2 years, another year, another night, a day, or whatever, you two folks got the little thing all the experience. I will tell you this, we've had a service on as I think. I appreciate it. Hope you got all that down, because I need to get a copy of
it. You get that down.
If we have it on recording, I'll be sure to get you a copy.
Well, you've had several accolades lately of being recognized for your outstanding service,
yeah.
So this is just an additional one.
Appreciate it.
I concur with what you said, Mr. Perry. If you'd like to nominate Dr. Howell, I'd be honored to second it.
Consider my comments a formal nomination for Dr. Howell to serve as the neutral member.
And I would second that wholeheartedly. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. It's unanimous. Dr. Howell is abstaining. Is there any other business that needs to come before the board? County's at peace, Ms. Clark?
Yes, sir. I will record the county at peace.
It's always a pleasant thing to do. It's been a good year.
It has
been a good year. If there's nothing else, do I hear a motion to adjourn?
I make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Until the next meeting, when will it be?
The next meeting will be December the
13th.
Thursday, December the 13th. Same place, same time, unless something happens. Motion on the floor to adjourn. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. matter of your opinion. It seems to have left from somewhere.
Can't borrow banks, but you got a half act.
Yeah.
I know, I've got one of those citizen bank things somewhere, that's about that one on the desk.
Now you.
I don't like those kind, I like the other kind.
You like the. Look, kind of, I've got one in my car.
I've got five or six, I just didn't pick one up, I took it out of my pocket. Thank you, gentlemen.
Do you have equipment?
Yes.
Because Dr. Howell mentioned, we may want to get you to sign this, you know, just in case something comes up.
I'll be glad.
Because I don't have one of my people.
I hope that y'all all have a happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
The Lord has indeed blessed me and my family, and I'm sure he has yours, and don't fail to stop and give him thanks.
We all have a lot to be thankful for.
I hope you have a lot to eat, don't get sick. Happy Thanksgiving to you. Good to see you.
Very. Ms. Weston, I hope you have a good Thanksgiving.
I hope you do as well.
Don't burn that turkey up.
I'm planning on not.
Get a chance to speak to them.
No, I don't do it.
Ms. Garston, we know Garston.
Lorenzi.
Garston, so he just also.
So, yeah, probably y'all gonna be at Rose.
Around Thanksgiving.
Yes, sir.
She put her turkey.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate all those accolades, I really didn't realize anybody deserved all that, but bless you, sir. It's hard to take my dead ass back.
That's true. Well, you're very kind, mom and dad speak very highly of you too.
Well, thanks, very great people. That's sort of a few people I know. Most of the people that I knew when I came to Florida, 64 years ago. Actually, three generations. I'm the dinosaur, right?
Well, you're blessed to have your health.
That's right.
That's right.
It was a little faster than that, but you don't want to think of heaven. I need to be well or die. This life story, when you take something next Tuesday, you know, what part of the country said, this drug may kill you. That's good news.
Well, you're looking good anyway.
Thank you.
Looks have never been a problem for you.
Whenever you run for something, I want you to be a first person.
I'm not running for anything. I'm not a politician. Thank you. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving to you too.
See you.
Bye.
Thank you.